TikTok has a massive problem. Girls are being kidnapped and forced to make videos, or at least that's what a lot of people believe. There are several theories going around about famous TikTokers being forced to make videos and make money through these videos for their kidnapper. Two of the most notable TikTokers that we will be discussing today are a sister duo named Innkastar Mimikliffi and a mother-daughter duo named Bebopandbebe. And these theories have been going on for a couple years, with their comment section being flooded, asking if they are in danger and telling them to wear a specific color in their next video to show that they're kidnapped. But the idea of an influencer being kidnapped and forced to make videos is nothing new. You might remember someone by the name of Marina Joyce and the infamous pink dress.
Hey guys.
Back in July of 2016, YouTuber Marina Joyce posted this video where she was advertising a woman's clothing brand. In the video, she was blinking a lot, often looked to the side, and overall just gave an unusual presence. And because of this, the internet was convinced that she was kidnapped. People were deciphering the video and seeing things that just weren't there, because it all turned out to be one giant hoax. 8 years later, even after police went to investigate, and even after this whole thing was debunked, you still got people going to re-uploads, not even her own videos, but re-uploads of her videos, people commenting that she's in danger and in need of help. And why this is significant is because in 2024, people are still putting on their detective caps and are obsessed with the idea that a kidnapper would force their prisoner to make TikTok cosplay and emoji dancing videos. So for today's video, we're gonna be taking a look at Innkastar Mimikliffi as well as Bebopandbebe. I've looked at these two people before, and the videos have done very well because I've uncovered or shed light to some really crazy things. I've shown that Innkastar Mimikliffi are just regular young women who go out and enjoy life at amusement parks and concerts, and I've also shown that Bebe may not be as innocent as we think. The purpose of this video is to put together everything that I've uncovered and expose these people who are faking a kidnapping for money. And I just want to put it out there, this video isn't meant to spread hate to any of the individuals, it's meant to spread awareness. Although they haven't blatantly said that they're kidnapped, by refusing to talk about the theories and putting fake hints in their videos to fuel these theories, they're contributing to it. People think that these TikTokers are being controlled by someone to make videos, but the reality is they're controlling you, the viewers, into believing they're kidnapped so that they can get fame and money for themselves. Meet Innkastar Mimikliffi, a sister duo based in Russia who make videos hand dancing to popular songs and use emojis to show how to do their moves. In their videos, you'll notice that they rarely blink, rarely make any facial expressions, and overall just give a very robotic presence. And because of this, people actually think that they're robots. Yes, you really have people thinking that this is some iRobot Westworld type of stuff, and that these TikTokers aren't human. The comments and theories get very ridiculous. For instance, there's a wannabe Sherlock Holmes who noticed that Innkastar put a monster emoji in her video and believes it's a message that a man kidnapped her. They think the monster represents some evil man that's holding them hostage, but the reality is the song that they're dancing to is called The Monster by Eminem and Rihanna. Like, what emoji do you want them to use? A carrot? People make these emojis mean whatever they want them to mean. It's part of confirmation bias, an important term that everyone should understand. It's essentially seeing what you want to see and forgetting what you don't want to see. So people notice that Innkastar Mimikliffi often look tired in the videos, and because of this, they think that the kidnapper is making them stay awake 24/7 and filming videos. But there's one problem. It's a filter. The filter is literally a no sleep filter. The theories have gotten absolutely ridiculous, and there's really no stopping them when each and every single one of their videos are spammed with comments like this, saying to wear a particular color to show that they're in danger. One detective video seriously thought that the candy emoji in this video was used to show they got put in a van after a stranger asked if they wanted candy.
So some people actually think that this TikTok is just a normal TikTok, but in my thoughts is that she picks the candy basically to tell us that if she got kidnapped and she got offered candy and they took her, but I think that I'm right.
Do these fans fail to realize that Innkastar Mimikliffi are adults? Like, they're not little kids. Like, if a 6-year-old got asked for candy, I mean, you know, maybe then they would get tricked, but like, they're in their early 20s. I'm in my early 20s. Like, they have money. They could go buy candy. They don't need to go up to some sketchy white van and go get free candy. I mean, they got money. Also, to make matters even worse, according to my own comments, apparently I'm kidnapped. Yes, someone really commented saying that IvanSteff, am kidnapped. Bro, like, are you serious right now?
Oh my God, maybe I'm kidnapped now.
The only way for this to stop is by having videos such as mine focusing on educating their child fan base and by having people comment that they're not kidnapped. If these two women really were kidnapped, they would not be allowed outdoors in heavily populated areas surrounded by hundreds or even thousands of people. Now this person gets it. Innkastar Mimikliffi are manipulating you, the viewers, into believing they're kidnapped so that they can get fame and money for themselves. On their Instagram, they have tons of photos of public places such as restaurants, amusement parks, and city streets. What kidnapper would let their victim go public skating? Just look how many people are surrounding Mimikliffi. If she was kidnapped and wanted to escape, she could easily signal for help or just run into the crowd. Like, she would just blend in, no problem. But on top of this, a kidnapper would not jeopardize themselves by going outdoors and revealing their identity. In the background of the photos on their Instagram have popular buildings or monuments where you can easily see the city of which they are located in, and a kidnapper would not allow this. They posted photos and videos with other people, including their fans who have spotted them in public. And on top of all this, if they really are kidnapped, then why has no one reported them to be kidnapped? Okay guys, pause. I gotta come forward and be honest with you. I've been lying to you this whole time. It turns out that the two really are kidnapped because Innkastar posted this photo on her Instagram and you can see the kidnapper in the background. Yup, just take a look at the comments. They can see the man. You can see the man right there through the mirror. Now, who is this scary man forcing Innkastar Mimikliffi to make hand dancing emoji videos? A cardboard cutout of Ryan Gosling.
Ooh, scary.
This just goes to show how easily children see what they wanna see. They see some male figure in the background and immediately believe that he is dangerous and a kidnapper. But the truth is, you're not dangerous just because you're a man, and men are not the only one who are dangerous. Now with that being said, it takes me to the second pair of TikTokers that we will be looking at, Bebopandbebe. So, Bebopandbebe, they're a mother-daughter duo people also think are kidnapped. Likewise, people spam the comments telling them to wear a specific collar to show that they're in danger. And people absolutely freak out when they wear a collar that was commented on the previous video. Now, many of the times, the comment that they're referring to was posted after the next video already came out, meaning that when a new video comes out, people go to the previous video and comment what they wore in that new video. And these people comment this stuff so that they can get likes. But either way, when literally every single collar in the rainbow was commented, Bebopandbebe are bound to wear one of them. Like, what do you want them to do? Wear an invisible cloak? Someone could comment the color yellow on 20 videos, and for 19 videos, Bebopandbebe may not wear the color yellow. But that one time they do wear the color yellow, they freak out and forget about those other 19 times of which they did not wear yellow. And this is confirmation bias. They forget about those 19 times they didn't wear yellow, which should mean that they're safe, and only remember the one time they wore yellow. Now, Bebopandbebe have never flat out said they're kidnapped, but the mother, Bebe, has done a lot of things which keep the conspiracy theories going. For example, the songs they've chose to use for the videos, such as this one which says, "Please come rescue me." Bebe has also purposely placed handcuffs in the background of her live stream and has done things that the comments on her live streams are telling her to do. Now, in my last video I posted about Bebopandbebe, I looked at two theories about who Bebe is in the real world. One of them being an ex-convict and the other being an adult performer who posted some very, very inappropriate pictures and videos. I originally found the theories on Reddit, I read the evidence, and looked for some more evidence myself. I've already talked about it, so I'm not gonna go into detail. If you want, you can watch my other video, but after everything that I read and uncovered, I strongly believe that Bebe is both an ex-convict and an ex-adult performer. And I'm not trying to hate on Bebe for this, but the significance of it is because people keep on thinking that some imaginary man is controlling Bebopandbebe, forcing them to make videos, and is abusing them. But the reality is, the person who's been forcing Bebop to make videos has been right in front of you this whole time. Bebe. Bebop has an older brother who hasn't been seen in years, but in his last video appearance, he apologized for having previously said that Bebe, his own mother, was forcing him to make videos.
First off, I want to apologize to my mom and my sister Bebop. I lied and I hurt them. I hurt their business, what they were trying to do.
And what did you lie about?
That I was forced.
Say it.
That I was forced.
Were you ever forced?
No.
Were you ever threatened?
No.
Was there any consequences to not doing a video?
No.
Did you like it at the end, being famous?
Yeah.
Okay, pause. The fact that she asked him if he likes being famous sounds a lot like gaslighting to me, because she's trying to justify that just because he liked being famous, it is okay for her to have forced him to be in videos. Ironically enough, this apology video seemed forced. Bebe's favorite SpongeBob character has gotta be Mr. Krabs, because she's absolutely money hungry. Last year, Bebe was supposed to be interviewed by a group called 15 Minute News, where she would finally break her silence about the kidnapping conspiracy theory, but in order to watch the interview, you had to pay for it. That's crazy. Imagine charging people money to hear you finally come forward and say that your own daughter is not kidnapped. It's really sad that the only way she'll say her daughter is safe is by getting money for it. And it's crazy to me that people like this who fake a kidnapping for views and money are allowed to be on these platforms. And mothers exploiting their daughters by forcing them to make videos for money is nothing new. We've got Piper Raquel's mom, who was sued by 11 members formerly part of her squad, and the allegations are disgusting. We've got Jenny Popach's mother, who's been accused of pimping out her own daughter. And we've got Danielle Cohen's mom, who, don't even get me started on that. The point of this video video is not to hate on these daughters, but it's to educate people that it is not just men who can endanger people. A trending example was Gypsy Rose Blanchard, who was a textbook definition of a mother exploiting her daughter for fame and money. There was no imaginary man, it was Gypsy's mother who was faking her illnesses and ruining her own daughter's life for fame and money. In the social media era, there are so many mothers who are exploiting their daughters. Rather than finding regular 9-to-5 jobs, they are using their daughters as money printing machines. Recently, Florida passed a law banning children under the age of 16 from using social media. Now, while I don't necessarily agree with that law, there is no doubt that people under the age of 12 are at risk when using social media. When you have 8-year-olds easily tricked about believing that these two groups of TikTokers are kidnapped, what else could they be tricked about? Ironically enough, those who believe that these TikTokers are kidnapped probably have a greater chance of being kidnapped compared to those who don't believe that they're kidnapped. Because people who believe these TikTokers are kidnapped have an inaccurate understanding of the world and what a kidnapping or abuse really looks like. Kids are essentially led to believe that if you post dancing videos on TikTok and wear a shirt that has a color on it, then you're kidnapped. Anyway guys, that's officially gonna do for this video. The purpose, once again, of this video was to put together everything, hopefully try to put a stop to these kidnapping conspiracy theories. They do more harm than good. People are devoting their attention to these TikTokers when in reality, there are probably people out there on social media who are actually in danger. But these TikTokers, Innkastar, Mimikliffi, Bebopandbebe, they are not in danger. They are fine. They are controlling you. They are controlling you and manipulating you into believing that they're kidnapped so you give them more views and money. It's really just creating false narratives about kidnapping. People think a kidnapping looks one way, but in reality, it looks a whole nother way. If you are both educated and entertain, please consider leaving a like on this video and subscribe if you haven't already. Also, feel free to share this video. What are your thoughts about this entire thing? Leave a comment down below. Let's start a discussion. But anyways, that's officially gonna do it for this video. So until next time, it's been IvanSteff. Peace. Also, yo, what do you think of the new setup? I got these nice nano leaves. Thinking about doing some other things, but this is for now. Yay. Bien, no. Yes, let me know. Okay.